Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Nursing Career. On this channel, you will see all the nursing related MCQs or golden key points. Please like my video and subscribe my channel. Today, I discuss about GMCH Nursing Officer Exam 2016. So now my first question is, question number first, while caring for a patient of bronchial asthma, you identified that patient respiratory condition has become critically worsened. Then, option A, there is increase in the intensity of wheezing. Option B, there is a decrease in the breath sound all over the chest. And option C, crepitation and wheezing are both present. And option D, the patient says, "I am feeling more breathless than when I came to," and its answer is there is increase in the intensity of wheezing. Question number second, the mask garment is used for treatment of option A, acute respiratory distress, option B, hemorrhagic shock, and option C, incontinence of urine, and option D, paraplegia, and its answer is a hemorrhagic shock. Question number third, the most common abdominal incision for gallbladder surgery is option A, McVume-Gridiron, option B, Kocher incision, and option C, Weissenthal incision, and option D, left paramedian incision, and its answer is a Kocher incision. Question number fourth, you are assessing a patient of acute pancreatitis for the complication of paralytic ileus. The key symptoms indicate the complication is option A, recurrent vomiting, option B, abdominal pain, and option C, inability to pass flatus, and option D, watery diarrhea, and its answer is the inability to pass flatus. So first, fifth question is, in the general anesthesia, the stage of excitement and dream is option A, stage 1, option B, stage 2, option C, stage 3, and option D, stage 4. And its answer is a stage 2. Question number 6. The post-operative exercise of huffing is used primarily to help the patient. Option A, make oxygen reach the alveoli. Option B, strengthen the chest muscles. And option C, reduce lung collapse. And option D, loosen the chest secretions. And its answer is loosen the chest secretions. Question number 7. While dressing the abdominal wound, on the fifth post-operative day, you observe that some intestinal loops are protruding outside. This is called option A, perforation, option B, evisceration, option C, wound dehiscence, and option D, intestinal hernia, and its answer is eviscerations. Question number 8. The high-frequency chest wall oscillation is used for option A, providing a high-frequency ventilation, option B, loosening a thick chest secretions, and option C, preventing pulmonary embolism, and option D, providing a cardiopulmonary resuscitation, and its answer is loosening thick chest secretions. Question number 9. The patient has a pressure ulcer in which subcutaneous fat is visible, but bone, tendon, or muscle is not exposed or visible. This is a stage 2 ulcer, stage 3 ulcer, stage 4 ulcer, and unstageable ulcer, and its answer is a stage 3 ulcer. Question number 10. An example of an open drainage system used in surgical wound is Jackson Perret drain, Hemovac, and T-tube biliary drain, and Penrose drain, and its answer is a Penrose drain. Question number 11. Paradoxical respiration is most commonly seen in option A, congestive heart failure, option B, obstructive airway disease, and option C, cardiac tamponade, and option D, flail chest, and the answer is flail chest. Question number 12. A patient with classical heat stroke will have dry skin, profuse sweating, cool skin, and normal body temperature, and its answer is a dry skin. Question number 13. The log roll turning method is used in lung abscess, cerebrovascular accidents, spinal injuries, and epilepsy, and its answer is a spinal injuries. Question number 14. A body temperature of 39 degrees centigrade is equivalent to a Fahrenheit temperature of option A 99, option B 100, and option C 101, and option D 102. and its answer is 102. Question number 15. An example of cervical skeleton traction on the device is Hello device, Works traction, Thomas splint, and Kramer wire splint, and its answer is Hello device. Question number 16. Is Z track technique of intramuscular injection is used to avoid nerves and veins in the path, reduce backward leakage of drug, reduce the pain of injection, reduce bleeding and hematoma, and its answer is reduce backward leakage of drug. Question number 17. A DEXA scan is used in diagnosis of breast cancer, osteoporosis, coronary artery disease, pulmonary embolism, and its answer is osteoporosis. Question number 18. Patient has burn over the front of chest and abdomen. The percentage of burn is calculated to be option A 9%, option B 18%, option C 24%, and option D 36%. And its answer is 18%, 9% chest and 9% abdomen. Question number 19. The patient with the following infection should be assigned to a negative pressure isolation room. Option A, laryngeal tuberculosis, herpes simplex, mycoplasma pneumonia, and impetigo. And its answer is laryngeal tuberculosis. Question number 20. In the usage of adjectives, the correct formation of the sentence is Ram is older than Shyam. Ram is older than Shyam. Older Ram is than is Shyam. And its answer is Ram is older than Shyam. Question number 21. In grammar, the sentence sun rises in the east is option A present continuous tense, simple present tense, past continuous tense, simple past tense. And its answer is a simple present tense. Question number 22. A positive over-the-counter pregnancy test is considered as a positive sign of pregnancy, presumptive sign of pregnancy, probable sign of pregnancy, and a positive sign of pregnancy. And its answer is a positive sign of pregnancy. Question number 23. Which type of cancer has the poorest prognosis? Squamous cell carcinoma, breast cancer, pancreatic cancer, and gastric cancer. And its answer is a squamous cell carcinoma. Question number 24. Which of the following is a vector of infection? Option A, infectious fly, a contaminated thermometer, contaminated ball, an infected person. And its answer is an infectious fly. Question number 25. And the last question. Which nursing action is essential when providing a continuous enteral feeding? Option A, elevating the head of bed. Option B, positioning the patient on left side. And option C, warming the formula above administering it. And option D, hanging the formula for 8 hours in the beginning of morning shift. And its answer is elevating the head of the bed. Thank you guys to watch my video and subscribe my channel.